Here's your wrestling news for September 23rd, 2020. And your headlines for today include: WWE Retribution reveal was met with laughter backstage during Raw. CM Punk reacts as well. Roman Reigns to undergo major changes to his ring gear and entrance music. WWE enters into an unexpected business. The Rock says it makes sense for him to face Roman Reigns at WrestleMania. WWE wrestler admits that he was legitimately choked out by John Cena. Hire Heath Slater campaign video features Flava Flav, Chuck Norris, and more. Breaking news as a former right-hand man of Vince McMahon to join AEW. WWE superstar refused John Cena's advice and got locker room heat. Roman Reigns takes a shot at Jon Moxley, explains why The Shield will never reunite. In an unexpected way, AEW takes a direct dig, in fact, insults Vince McMahon, and more. We're kicking off today with news from Raw as Retribution revealed that they've signed contracts with WWE this week, but things didn't go down as planned. According to WrestleVotes, the group received laughter backstage when they debuted their new looks on this week's show, and with names like T-Bar, Mace, and Slapjack, the group appears to be in a creative hole that might be impossible to climb out of. Things go from bad to worse when you look up what these new names mean on Urban Dictionary, as the definitions for the three names are: Mace, a heavy spiked metal club used for breaking heads, a suitable substitute for the pepper spray. T-bar, when one is wearing a thong or G-string, they sit down, it sticks out, and you see a T-bar. And slapjack, the act of ejaculating on one's hand and then slapping another person in the face. Unsurprisingly, fans on Twitter had a field day mocking Retribution, as did CM Punk, who took to Instagram to share his own reaction. There, the former world champion posted a picture of one of Retribution, who wears a mask similar to Jason Voorhees, and referred to it as a paper plate. A few superstars were more sympathetic, with one saying they feel bad for Mia Yim and Mercedes Martinez, saying, "They worked so long and are facing a battle to not make this look as dumb as it is." One SmackDown star theorized that the stable is now only on Raw because it's a longer show, but nobody's been told why they were taken off of SmackDown. There's also no word on what Retribution's long-term direction is, though we do know that absolutely everyone thought the new names were ridiculous, with one superstar saying, "It sounds like something out of a bad movie or game, but I'm not sure Vince plays games or watches movies anymore." With mocking from fans and stars alike, it may be impossible for Retribution to get out of this one, and though WWE likely didn't mean for this universal ridicule, it might have been a good idea for WWE to simply let Retribution be themselves. Now, Roman Reigns changed a lot about himself when he returned as the newest client of Paul Heyman to win the Universal title, but the Tribal King isn't done changing things up. Speaking during a meet-and-greet for Mania Club to raise money for Connor's cure, Reigns revealed that he'll be tweaking his look, saying, "I've been wearing a SWAT outfit my entire career, so I'm gonna stick with those pants. If you watch on Sunday, you'll probably see me with my shirt off. That'll be the change. That's going to be the only difference. I never wanted the outfit to be the costume for me. I don't want my outfit to be the superstar." Speaking about changing his entrance music, which he's used since his 2012 main roster debut with The Shield, he said, "That's a little more than me creating my own music. We have to go through the channels with that one. It's not like I came out and I'm an ultra bad guy. You've seen it in little steps and little layers. I want all the nuances to add up. Hopefully down the line, once more drastic things happen and the story unfolds." In that same call, the Universal Champion was asked to choose between his brothers in The Shield and the Samoan Dynasty, and the new, edgier Reigns took a shot at Jon Moxley when he said he doesn't think The Shield will ever be back. He said, "Moxley really screwed that up, didn't he? He messed around and just left us. I don't think The Shield will ever be recreated or brought back. That's just not a situation because Mox went to AEW. It's just, we were so good. Honestly, I think we did the reunion thing a little too much over the last 3 years." Just a few months ago, fans would never think Roman would badmouth his Shield brother, and given his new attitude since his SummerSlam return, his gear and music should reflect that, and fans will have to wait until this Sunday's match against Jey Uso to see the shirtless big dog. We're moving from the ring to the vineyard next, as WWE has teamed with Wines That Rock, a lifestyle wine company, to release two wines all about WWE. Now, fans can pre-order bottles of an Undertaker 2018 Cabernet Sauvignon, which will celebrate the Phenom's 30 years in WWE, as well as an Ultimate Warrior 2019 Zinfandel, which will come with one of three unique corks, produced with different images and sayings from the Hall of Famer. $100 plus shipping will get you two bottles, and you can mix and match if you desire. Vince McMahon has been a lot of things in his career, and now he can be your sommelier, and fans can find out more details by going to WWEWines.com. Back to the ring now, and The Rock has once again weighed in on a potential WrestleMania match with Roman Reigns. In a video on his own channel, the Brahma Bull spoke about facing his blood on the biggest stage, saying, "People always say, well, if you were to go back to WrestleMania, who would be the opponent that you would face? It feels like the one that would make sense, right, would be Roman. In terms of box office draw, it would be huge." If this happened, it'd be The Rock's first match since his 8-second victory over Eric Rowan at WrestleMania 32, and The Great One joked about who'd win this dream collision. He said, "I'm not going down that road because I know how that conversation goes. Listen, here's what we're thinking, Roman beats you now at this WrestleMania, but listen, before you guys say anything, then on the next one, that's when, but I'd be honored to not only share the ring with Roman and go back to the WWE, but of course I would be honored to have him raise his hand." Rock's idea of two matches so both men could win is identical to his WrestleMania matches with John Cena, and while we don't know if he'll return to the squared circle, a match with the new Roman Reigns would be a box office smash. Now, if you've ever listened to Stone Cold's podcast, you've heard the Rattlesnake say John Cena should tighten his STF, but one person who may disagree is Edge. On WWE Untold, Edge and Cena discussed their Unforgiven 2006 TLC match, where Cena used the ladder to add a new level of pain to the STF. Edge said, "The ladder added an extra distance from his arms, he actually choked me out. You can watch me pass out. I just remember hearing an alarm and thinking I was late for an Air Canada flight. When I came to, it was me making the noise and I was looking up at the Air Canada Center logo. I had never been choked out before. Then it was just, get to the next thing." Fortunately, Edge was able to continue the match, which was won by Cena, and though Big Match John also spoke about the mixed reaction he receives from audiences, we doubt any Cena haters want to try to break his STF, especially on a ladder. Over to Raw, and this week's episode was a frustrating watch for fans, and that's reportedly the same attitude shared backstage. According to Ringside News, Paul Heyman's presence as a creative leader of the Red Brand is greatly missed, as he was the only one who told Vince the truth about his product. A member of creative said that Heyman had no arguments or agendas, and he was very respectful to Vince, and that respect was given back, especially since Heyman's vision was to build superstars for the next decade. Now, that vision is no longer around, as that source said, "The creative process has hit rock bottom," and added that the team is tasked with cranking out content instead of focusing on a long-term plan for Raw. One tenured member of creative added, "It's hard to say it's frustrating because there is so much busy bee work to do, you don't have any time to be frustrated." There's no shortage of proof that current plans aren't working out, such as Retribution's debut being met with laughter backstage, and it's being reported that McMahon himself came up with the idea without a long-term direction in sight. "We are sure there's many in the company that wish someone would get in McMahon's ear and help him book the group a bit differently, but for now, Vince remains the deciding factor in all WWE content, and Retribution is his idea." Now, not too long ago, Gerald Briscoe was told that he was no longer needed by Vince McMahon, but that's not going to keep the Hall of Famer retired. On social media, Briscoe has been teasing a big announcement, and in a recent tweet, dropped a big hint he's working with AEW, saying he can't wait to tell fans his big news. With decades upon decades of experience, AEW could certainly do with someone like Briscoe, who is credited as the talent scout who brought a young Brock Lesnar into WWE. We'll have to see what's next for Briscoe, as he may already have his eye on people who'd be perfect for wrestling, and whilst AEW doesn't have an official school like WWE, they do have places like QT Marshall's gym where Briscoe could send stars to be polished up. We've got more John Cena news next, as with him being one of the biggest stars in wrestling, it's usually handy for a wrestler to take his advice, and you'll be noticed if you don't. In the past, Alex Riley and John Cena have had some pretty famous heat, with Riley still throwing digs at Cena every so often, and during the Arn show, Arn Anderson spoke about what happened to Riley, saying, "There's a famous story that he was offered some help from John Cena, and he seemed less than enthused or interested, which would have immediately made its way back to the locker room and to the office. I'm sure it was around that time that his water got cut off." Now, A-Rai is trying to become an actor, a career that would probably help having Cena as a contact, and though there doesn't seem to be any heat between the two, refusing the 16-time world champion's advice certainly didn't help Riley in the WWE locker room. We're focusing on WWE's April 15th releases, as Heath Slater has now found himself in Impact Wrestling, but he's technically not hired by the company. That hasn't stopped Heath from trying to get a job, and on Cameo, the one-man band dropped some serious dough to put himself over. Slater paid David Hasselhoff, Flava Flav, Nancy Kerrigan, and Chuck Norris to give him endorsements, which collectively cost him at least $900. And it's worth noting that Cameo's prices on the app are somehow more expensive than the website. Hopefully, Impact will listen to the words of Walker Texas Ranger and Baywatch's Mitch Buchanan, among others, as these promos could get quite expensive for Heath if he carries on. Over to AEW now, and though FTR are doing big things as the World Tag Team Champions, fans will remember the duo's final days in WWE, where Vince McMahon wanted them to be clowns. The attire they almost wore on TV became a popular joke amongst wrestling fans, and two people who got in on that joke this week are the Young Bucks, who've been wanting to wrestle FTR for a long time. Years ago, Matt Jackson said they would one day wrestle the Revival and that everyone will rejoice when they do, though Dax Harwood replied this week, saying that he's pleased they paid thousands to get out of their WWE deals and go to AEW because the Bucks were too afraid to come to them in WWE. The Bucks fired back by wearing an attire like FTR would have been forced to dress in if they stayed in WWE, and those outfits were previously worn during a Being the Elite sketch. The Bucks added that if they went to WWE, then FTR would have looked like this, and there's clearly no love lost between the two teams. So far, FTR and the Bucks have yet to clash in an AEW ring, though we're sure that match will happen down the line, and everyone will rejoice when it does. And we're ending today with NXT UK, as the brand could soon see a huge name join the show. During Wrestling Observer Radio, Dave Meltzer said that he's heard of plans for Davey Boy Smith Jr. to be joining NXT UK after his current contract with MLW expires in December. There's always the chance that MLW could let him out early, and with WWE inducting Smith's father into the Hall of Fame this year, that certainly helps the chances of his return. We'll have to see whether the former tag team champion makes a return to WWE, as he could bring a lot of attention to the NXT UK brand, though it seems fans will have to wait until December to see him back in a WWE ring.